Oh, hello.
I'm Marcus Mastillo.
Welcome to Crash Course Industrial Age for Dummies. Welcome. So here's some quick industrial age things that you should know. Tycoons are the wealthy people in the business and industry, such as John D. Rockefeller and Andrew Carnegie.
Rockefeller was a co-founder of the Standard Oil Company, and that dominated the other oil industries. He was an American philanthropist. Now, Andrew Carnegie was a Scottish-American industrialist who led the enormous expansion of the American steel industry into the late 19th century. He built a leadership role as a philanthropist for the American and the British Empire. Whoa, that was interesting. What do you got, Tomás?
I have immigration. Immigrants arrived mainly from the Northern and Western Europe. They left their European homes to escape economic problems. To native-born Americans, the newcomers seemed alien. They had to adjust to industrial labor and unfamiliar languages. What do you got, Jacob?
Oh boy, do I have something interesting for you. There's this thing related to immigration called xenophobia. Xenophobia is the discrimination of foreigners or the hate of another culture. Some current day examples of xenophobia are Donald Trump and the KKK. Donald Trump frowns upon the immigration of illegal Hispanics into the country of the United States of America, and the KKK commits hate crimes and looks sadly and hastily upon blacks.
Moving on, Teddy Roosevelt was our great nation's 26th president. Before Teddy was a president, he was a New York City police commissioner. During this industrial age, there were many corrupt cops and officers that dealt with the mafia and also did drugs. He served as a president from 1901 to 1909.
Wait, what? This just in. News from our president.
Oh, nice Barbies, Tomás. During the industrial era, the government did not control or manage big businesses at all. So, these big companies were able to buy other smaller companies until there was no other competing companies. This created monopolies, and since the government did not regulate these companies, they were able to become supermassive rich empires. I'm Barack Obama, and I approve this message.
Man, do we have an awesome president. Another factor that played into the progressive era is the 18th Amendment. This was established for the prohibition of alcoholic beverages in the United States. This declared the illegal production, transport, and sale of alcohol. The consumption and private possession was still legal and still occurred. Another factor that played into the progressivism era was muckrakers. They were basically reform-minded American journalists who wrote largely for all popular magazines. They worked to expose social ills and corporate and political corruptions. The muckrakers also raised awareness of social injustices, inequality, corruption, and abuse of political power. Upton Sinclair and Ida Tarbell are some of the muckrakers.
Wow, that's pretty mucked up.
Jacob Riis was believed to or not be a Danish-American social reformer, muckraking journalist, and social documenter and photographer. He wrote many books about this time period. And now to...
Dude, you said my name in your passage.
Danish?
Danish! You know what? You... This is pretty mucked up. I quit. I'm out of here.
Well, what do we do now?
We could have the president fill in.
Did somebody say president? Another example of a muckraker is Upton Sinclair. Upton Sinclair attracted his fame in 1906 after he wrote the muckraking novel, The Jungle. It exposed all of the disgusting and unsanitary conditions of the U.S. meatpacking industry. This caused a lot of public uproar. This later contributed to the passing of the Food and Drug Act and the Meat Inspection Act.
Where did Danish go?
Man, this new job really, really blows. I was reading a book the other day. What was it called? The Jungle by Upton Sinclair. He really illuminated my own life. It's like he truly gets me. It was portraying the corruption and poor working and living conditions given to these workers who put in all their effort and time into earning very little and doing these disgusting jobs.
That was weird. What do you have on the FDA, Mr. President?
Well, after Upton Sinclair brought dangerous food manufacturing practices to America's attention, Congress passed the Pure Food and Drug Act and the Meat Inspection Act in 1906. This forced meat factories to have sanitary conditions, inspection of animals and meat, and correct labeling to prevent adulteration or misbranding.
And then the FDA was born. Hey, Tomás, can you provide some insight on square deals?
Yeah, sure. The square deals were basically the three C's, known as corporations, consumers, and conservation. When dealing with the corporations, we have the Northern Securities Company of 1904 and the Sherman Antitrust Act. When dealing with consumer protection, there's the Pure Food and Drug Act, the Meat Inspection Act, and the Upton Sinclair's book, The Jungle, which he explained. Another one of the C's is conservation, which deals with the Forest Reserve Act of 1891, the U.S. Forest Service of 1906, and the White House Conference on Conservation in 1908. Marcus, can you give me some more important insight on the other laws that were put into place?
Gladly. Now let's welcome back our friend to take a seat.
To take a seat?
Yes.
I get to sit down with you.
With us.
With them.
Yes.
Thank you. Times have been tough since I've left the station, but I have picked up a thing or two. Would you like to see?
Yes.
Ready?
Whoa! What were we just talking about?
One of those like amendment things or something like that.
There we go. All right. Another big change that happened during the Industrial Age that made even more changes was the 19th Amendment. The 19th Amendment gave women the right to vote, and Congress passed it on June 4th, 1919. Americans consider this to be a radical change in the Constitution. Well, that does it for Crash Course Industrial Age for Dummies. What do we do now?
Let's boogie!
I have immigration.
Immigrants arrive mainly from...
Oh, hello. You can adjust to industrial labor and unfamiliar languages.
When I grab people, when I daddy, when I mean